Well, hello and welcome back to Strasbourg, France, game day two, Belgium versus Slovenia at the FIBA Women's Eurobasket competition. Shona Thorburn here alongside Czech international Teresa Brundtlebud. Big matchup tonight. Belgium taking on Slovenia. I think it's a must-win type situation for Belgium. Slovenia obviously feeling good after their big win yesterday over Turkey. Maybe that upset loss for Belgium over Bosnia here already today. Turkey 54, Bosnia 64. Their second win of the tournament already. Teresa, I'm going to let you talk about Slovenia. There you see the standings. 2-0 for Bosnia. Slovenia 1-0. Belgium 0-1. Do they have what it takes to win today?
I think both teams come in with a different momentum into this game because Slovenia beating Turkey by 25 points in yesterday's game, playing actually really nice, excellent basketball, exactly what they wanted, with Lisset scoring 17 points, 8 rebounds, 4 steals, and it was a 17 points versus Turkey, her personal high in the women's Eurobasket. And one more, Teja Oblak as well, 14 points, 6 assists, 3 steals, such presence on the court. To be honest, the mental state, I think, is going to be very important today, because if the Belgians going to hit some shots which they were missing yesterday, I think they could calm themselves down. It will be really, really nice game to watch. It will be interesting to see Shante Evans, because I think she did an amazing job yesterday guarding points of Hollingsworth, and it will be interesting to see her match up with Emma Mesman today.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's an interesting matchup, and like you said, it's kind of whoever gets going first could possibly be the winners at the end of the game. Looking at Belgium here, obviously we have the Mestak sisters. Dallaire, a big part of this team. Julie Allemand. I thought Geldof checked in and did some good stuff for them. You have Billy Massey making her first big-time appearance here at a Eurobasket women's competition. Big name that we don't see is Jenna Rahman. That freak injury, she broke her thumb on the way to this event, had surgery. Everything's going well, and she should be back for Tokyo. So don't worry, Belgian basketball fans. And let's never forget Messeman. That being said, we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to have the national anthem of Slovenia.
For the national anthem.
L'hymne national de la Slovénie.
First, the national anthem of Slovenia. And now the national anthem of Belgium.
Thank you.
Both teams excited and ready to go here. Second game of the day. Group C action. Right before, we saw Bosnia get a win over Turkey. Both those teams also play in the Group C. Today's referees, Karak Katsounis from Greece, Vassolo from Malta, and Manis from Estonia.
Here we will see Slovenia's first five, Lisek, Oblak, Prezi, Friskovic, Evans. Expected first five, the same five where they went into that game yesterday against Turkey. Lisek, she said before this championship that their goal will be actually to qualify for the qualification for the World Cup next year. And I think first performance definitely showed it up. Here she is. The player who stand out yesterday with 17 points and rebounds, four steals. Here we see some more stats. She's playing Dynamo Kursk, Russian Premier League at the club level. I think the Slovenia is a very consistent team. They showed us yesterday each quarter they have played very consistently. They didn't have up and downs. And I think that's going to be quite key point in today's game. Damir Grčić, the play caller for Slovenia. Really good game playing yesterday against Turkey. I think he came out with really good aggressive defense against Turkish team, playing Shante Evans down, matching up Quanta Hollingsworth to get her off the game.
And now your starting five for Belgium, Mestag, Dallaire, Messemann, Linskens, and Julie Allemand. No surprise, it was the same starting five that they had yesterday. They don't have Anne Waters or Jana Ramon with them. I do believe if both of them are healthy, we will see them in Tokyo for the Olympics. And that player, in my opinion, Emma Messemann, one of the best players in the world right now. 24 points, 13 rebounds, 5 assists. She's won at every level. She won this year for EuroLeague with Ekaterinburg. She's won in the WNBA. Can she now propel her team to win tonight? Coach Philip Mestag, he knows what it takes. I'm sure he was disappointed. These women are going to be ready. They are all disappointed with their performance yesterday. Bad, bad shooting night. 3 for 28 from the three-point line yesterday. Nothing was going in. They need to figure that out, but they also need to be able to defend because the Slovenia team can score, and they can score fast.
Yeah, absolutely. They also have some depth in the bench yesterday, proving that 15 points of the bench players in yesterday's game compared to really zero from the bench players of a Belgium team. So it'll be important as well how much minutes the bench players can get and still keep up the tempo in the game, because we've seen the Belgium team yesterday were dealing a little bit with the fatigue in that game. And but I must say that the Belgium team might have a little mental advantage, because last time they faced, and for the first time they faced Slovenia, was in quarterfinals in 2019, the Eurobasket, and they beat by 5 points the Slovenian team. So, you know, 55 points in yesterday's game, I think Belgium will definitely want to improve that, because that's the lowest in the group phase since 1999, as we can see now on the screen, and they won't be happy. Definitely won't be happy with that.
Yeah, absolutely. You see the players there with ice on the back of their necks. Teresa and myself wish we had someone also putting ice on the back of our nets, because it is hot here in Strasbourg, France. Putting ice on the back of our nets because it is hot here in Strasbourg, France. Players coming onto the court. See the leaders talking.
You can see Tao Black's greeting the referees, obviously based on the rules. You can't shake the hands. this year's championship.
Nope, but we are able to have fans in the stands, and boy is it good to see some of these Belgian Cats supporters along with Slovenia. Well, hello and welcome to the FIBA Women's EuroBasket Competition 2021 edition. And Julie Alemán, 2 points for Belgium already. Shona Thorburn alongside Teresa Brandlebad, bringing you today's action. Turnover for Slovenia. Quick update. Belgium, in my opinion, upset yesterday by Bosnia. 55-70, and Slovenia with that big win over Turkey in game day one action, Group C. Alemán to Messemann, and it's good. That's a good sign if you're a Belgian fan.
That's a completely different beginning into the game as we've seen yesterday. And another steal, Belgium team as well. So not ideal start for Slovenia with the 2 turnovers right away, but so much better start for Belgium with 2 quick baskets and 2 steals.
Good job by Kim Mestag there, picking up full court. Linskins finds Messemann. Messemann kicks it back out to Alemán. Alemán finds Messemann. Finds a cutting to the layer. What beautiful basketball. That is what we're used to seeing. Nice pass from Messemann. Great finish by Dallaire.
When you have a player coming from a weak side, that's such a weapon for the teams, because normally defense focus on the ball and they sometimes forget the weak side.
Oblak trying to create something for Slovenia. Lisets puts it on the floor. She drives on Messemann. They obviously know each other well, and she scores the first 2 points of the day for Slovenia. They play against each other, Messemann and Lisets, in the Russian Super League.
Yeah, Lisets.
Also in EuroLeague.
Yeah, Lisets, Dynamo, Kursk, Russian Premier League, Emma Messemann, Yekaterinburg. So, as you mentioned, knowing each other very well, and it's going to be a great matchup to watch.
So a foul there on Preza from Slovenia. Linksons gets it back to Alemán. Alemán goes baseline, and I think Shante Evans is going to pick up her first personal. But that's already the 3rd team foul for Slovenia.
Yeah, as we mentioned, that's not the ideal one, because if Slovenia is going to have another foul, it's way too early to send Belgium to the foul line.
Linskins, good job getting positioned down low over Evans, and she scores.
You know, you asked me the other game if things can motivate players if it doesn't go their way, and I think Belgium started so much better than yesterday. Look at that. Great defense, great offense. I think that's the Belgium we know from the previous years. And that's actually the Belgium who wants to be on the podium at this championship.
Absolutely. Dallaire picking up a loose ball foul on that last play. So Slovenia ball out of bounds. Nice drive, but she isn't able to finish. Friskovic for Slovenia, but they do get the ball back. So they'll have another opportunity. Evans, Prizel, Oblak wide open. She won't hesitate. Her shot a little short, and now Belgium are running. Skip pass to Alemán. She goes inside. Nice cut by Dallaire. 2 times we've seen that.
And I think Friskovic really needs to watch her play more than the ball, because at the moment, I think she gets quite distracted with the ball action, and she forgot that Dallaire is such a threat from that guard position. And that was a great 2 times cut behind the player's back.
Yeah. Quick timeout called here by coach Damir Grigic. Let's listen in.
We are not aggressive on the ball. Be on deny, play guard. We can 1 small foul to do. Hey, no offense. Let's go to side. To side on Frigi, okay? Watch out. Go hard out. Hey. If we score, we go on cross. If we score, we go on cross. Hey, cross, how many fouls?
Yeah, you can see Belgium shooting 5-5 at the moment. That's almost like a different team compared to yesterday. We've been seen like number one many times and for the long time in this game. In yesterday's game. So as we've seen, Coach Gergic was telling his players that they need to increase the aggressivity on the ball and doesn't let Belgian players to create so easily, because they receive the ball and they have time to look for their players to come off weak sides or to the ball. Too much time to play. So let's see. Slovenia had really aggressive defense yesterday against the Turkish. So can they bring it back to make it a little bit more difficult for Belgium?
Yeah, like you said, it's kind of night and day, apples and oranges for this Belgium team. Look at them putting the pressure on here. Almost forced the turnover. Maybe they do, and they do. So another turnover for Slovenia with the pressure.
Yeah, that's three early turnovers for Slovenia. It means two extra possessions for Belgium. And they're really punishing it effectively.
Baric on the court now for Slovenia. Dallaire, she takes her time. One-on-one coverage, has a little bit of a height difference. She doesn't get the basket. Now Slovenia running, and this is the kind of tempo that they want to play with. Baric. She stops. And one!
Yeah, this calls experience, let's say.
Absolutely.
Baric didn't rush the decision, being right in the middle of the paint. Look at that jump, the shot fake. And Julia Alemán tried to block that first shot.
Might have got away with a sportsmanlike almost, because it wasn't really a play on the ball. And Baric is able to convert the three-point play, but no one sees Mestak. Linksins decides to settle it down, though. Ball goes inside. Oh, no. Little two-point shot for Linksins.
You know what? If Emma Mesman has mismatch and she's still covered, okay, what else to do than just take the shot? Has been, I think Evalisic could have passed that ball a little bit to her teammate, a little bit more, quicker, get the touches in. What Belgium teams is excellent in, how many times the players touch the ball with them.
Mestak, three-point jump shot, that's off. She really struggled from three yesterday. She was 2 of 12 from the three-point line and just 4 of 21. Three-point shot by Lisitz, and it's good! But look at that.
The best response is to have a quick break. You know, when the team celebrate, just go and punish them. And that's what another great break from Belgium.
And that's disappointing get-back defense, especially after a made basket. You can't give up an easy layup like that. Prezel back to Baric. Baric doesn't hesitate. Her shot is way off. Belgium running. Dallaire with the ball. Passes up to Mestak. Mestak stops.
Look at that spacing. Look at that movement on the players. Everyone's getting touches offensively.
Linskins, and it's good. That's the kind of movement that we are used to seeing, and we really didn't see that movement and speed yesterday from the Belgium team.
Yeah, absolutely. Linskins didn't score in yesterday's game, and today she already has 6 points.
Baric inside to Lisic. Great pass.
Almost wishing there's someone on a split line to cover this lob pass. I think Kim Mestak was a little bit too high, so she couldn't help for this easy pass.
Mestak finds Bestman. She drives baseline. Yeah.
That was a little bit too early foul, I think, from Nika Baric, because, but to be honest, if you're guarding the best player, one of the best players in the world, I think you don't really think if you give her a meter to go or not. So, yeah, experience foul, let's say, four fouls for Slovenia right now, and any other foul is going to be rewarded by two free throws.
Hannah Mestag, sorry, checking in along with Julie Van Loo for Belgium. Linskins finds Mestag in the corner. She lets it fly, and it's good.
And again, we've seen this shot after an amazing movement on the offensive half. Everyone got touches. Everyone had moved. And as you mentioned, that's the Belgium we know.
Nice offensive rebound. Lisic, well off, tries to find her rebound. She couldn't. Van Loo. Turnover, but they get it back. Little jump shot for Mestag. Her shot's off.
Yeah, we have to say Mestag is definitely not in the rhythm what we're used to with her, but we've seen it in yesterday's game. Even though she's not contributing points-wise with her long-distance shots and stuff, she's still quite beneficial to the team. She's putting the body down for her team. She's playing great defense, but I think she's praying for to get her wrench back.
Yeah, you know, if there was a statistical category. Oh, look at this steal. She heard you.
Exactly.
I mean, she did have six steals yesterday, but it was the sacrifice, her diving on the ball, you know, sacrificing her body, the hustle plays. She was trying to give absolutely everything to her Belgium team yesterday, and unfortunately, they came up short, but you can't say that she didn't give 100% effort in
no,
yesterday's game.
Absolutely agree with it, but unfortunately, she's one of the players who's scoring plus 10 points per game, and I think Belgium scoring only 55 in yesterday's game, so it's very hard to win games. When you barely score over 50. So I think in today's game, it will be very important she contributes with her points as well.
And you know what I like here? You see her at the free throw line. It's her first attempt from the free throw line today. But for shooters, sometimes when your shot's not falling, it's a good idea. Well, it's a good idea if you could try and get to the free throw line. And, you know, you go over your form. You take your breath. Like, those were two perfect free throws by a good free throw shooter, but also a good shooter. Maybe that'll give her a little bit more confidence next time she's at the three-point line and open.
Yeah, we could see a change in defense. And Belgium team playing a zone pressing full court, and now they went back into the zone defense.
Evans against Massey. Nowhere really to go for Evans, and they're going to call a double dribble on her. Good defense there by Belgium.
Yeah, they have felt that pain, so obviously Shanta Evans didn't have any easy task to do. Look at that defense of young Messi, and Linskins in there as well. Yeah, it's hard. I think you gotta play a little bit the defense to stretch them off the floor to open up that space for Evans to play. So send some player to cut through, so defense has to move.
And that's now, I believe, the fifth turnover for Slovenia. Van Loo to Dallaire. Dallaire drives baseline, difficult reverse layup. She misses, and Slovenia's running. Good get back defense by Belgium. Baric goes inside to Evans. Messman guarding her. Nothing is coming easy for Slovenia.
Yeah, and again, it was almost identical situation when Shanta Evans was posting up, this time the Messman on her, and really easy job because she's experienced enough to not foul her and wait for that block shot.
Quick shot here by Prezel, I think it is. No, sorry.
Crochel.
Crochel.
Mm-hmm.
Moving screen on number 35. Van Loo for Belgium. Trebet was on the receiving end of that hit. Kershaw trying to get something to go, and it goes off her leg or her foot.
I'm quite surprised that Taya Oblak sits on the bench. I don't know if coach wants to save some minutes, but this early in the game,
I'm not sure who went off, but the ref seems to, he didn't hesitate, so. Messman outside to Mestag. She'll let it fly. No good. Rebounding foul. I think it's going to go against Billy Massey. And Slovenia gets to shoot two free throws.
Yeah, those fouls are, I know you're hustling for the ball and stuff, but those fouls are quite unnecessarily, because obviously, especially when you're in the team foul troubles, because that's what we see now, Slovenian player on a foul line, and she didn't really have to put too much effort to get it. It's Pezzo, no? No, pardon, it's not. My forward, it's Senichar.
And she takes advantage of, like you said, that kind of maybe unnecessary foul. So the score, 21-12, just under 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. And she'll go out.
And we see Taya Oblak back on the court, and Riskovec as well. Zone defense from Slovenia.
Messman. She's gonna see what she can do. And that's what she can do.
That's what she can do. Actually, it showed like zone defense, but I don't think it really was defense zone. It was more they were showing off and then getting to man to man.
Oblak drives. Mm. Nice little reverse layup for her.
Way too easy. Way too easy for Taya Oblak. She's gonna take it.
Mestag turns it over.
You can see both coaches are rotating their players quite a lot early in the game, just giving them some time to rest. So obviously the heat is high in here, and it's important to keep the high tempo of this game.
Oblak. Nice offensive rebound.
Oh,
Messman gets back and will be credited with a block, though. Messman finds Linkskin. She goes up and is able to draw the foul against Oblak. I think she got there just a little bit too late.
Yeah, and that was, again, a great cooperation between two bigs. And Mazeman has seen Linsken cutting the ones to the rim. It's always a pleasure to watch when two bigs can play with each other.
Shots for Linskins here. She converts the first.
Yeah, Linskins playing in Magnolia Campobasso, Italian highest division. So plenty of experiences as well.
She makes the second
for the center. Zone defense from Belgium.
Riskovic to Oblak. Oblak, sorry. Tough shot. But she was worried about the Belgium running. Worried about the shot clock there.
Gorsic. Linskins.
Pretty good defense there by Slovenia.
Yeah, absolutely. Great defense from Gorsic. Quite physical, and she bumped Linskins to stop her going all the way down to the rim. Great defense.
Well, at the end of 10 minutes, Belgium 25, Slovenia 14. And talk to me a little bit about the difference in this Belgian team we're seeing here today compared to yesterday.
I think it's quite obvious. Here we see some stats, and I think that percentage 69-42 and 33-3 is already saying the difference compared to yesterday, when we've seen very low numbers against them facing Bosnia and Herzegovina. So I really am pleased to see back Belgium with the style of basketball that they are known by, and that is an excellent ball movement, a strong team play, and great compound defense they're playing, because at the moment I think Slovenia are struggling a little bit to find any open positions. The bigs and everyone of the Belgium team, when they set up that zone defense, it's really hard for them to attack it. So I think it would be really nice if Slovenia is going to hit some long distance shot as well. But to be honest, I think we're going to see Belgium packing that inside for the most of the game, because so far it really works.
Yeah, Slovenia 6-25 yesterday from the three-point land. And Belgium were 3 of 28 from three-point range yesterday. So I like the fact that Belgium were being aggressive, and you know, they've only attempted 3 three-point shots today, I believe it was. So, you know, go aggressive, try and see what you have, and then maybe that'll open things up on the perimeter and you'll have more time to take your time and shoot your outside shot. Well, start of the second quarter here in Strasbourg, France. Belgium taking on Slovenia. Oh. What a big time block by Linskins.
And you know what? That's the fifth team block of Belgium team. It definitely doesn't make it any easy for Slovenian players to go under the basket. Look at that.
I mean, that wasn't, you know, I just want to get a touch on the ball. That was how far can I hit the ball away. Slovenia get the ball inbounds. Lisic, turnover. Julia Mons running. She's going to slow it down, maybe. Dallaire to Messman. Dallaire finds a wide open Mestag, and she's still... I mean, these are good shots.
Yeah, that's
They're
absolutely.
Just not going in consistently, which we're not used to. Lisic with her...
Oh, look at that fast break.
Again, that's two times now.
Wow.
Belgium have been able to score after a made basket.
And you know, it takes really, like they know what they're supposed to run today, and they do have the taste of going, and they want to go, they have energy. Even though Kim Messer is struggling offensively still, I feel like the other players stepped up and they playing their game, you know. They're having 10 assists so far, Belgium team, and that tells you a lot. It's only beginning of the second quarter. Yeah.
And another turnover for Slovenia. Julie Alamon. Oh, I think she was trying to hit Messman. And now Oblak to Baric. Baric intimidated by Linskins, I think, and decided not to go up, but she finds Lisitz. Lisitz. Wide open shot for Oblak in the corner, and she misses.
It wasn't bad play from Slovenia. They actually used the patience to really find an open player, and who else? Oblak could have been that player. Oh, look at that.
Nice pass. Messman to Mestag. What good ball movement from this Belgium team. And Messman already has 4 assists.
Yeah, incredible performance. 3 blocks, 4 assists, and 8 points shooting 100% so far only at the beginning of the second quarter. I think it just confirms and shows our worth about her being one of the best players in the basketball at the moment.
Damir Gregic from Slovenia wants to talk it over with his team.
Samo pogledajte face vaše, samo pogledajte vaše face. 13 pik, gubimo tekmo, pa 30 minut se še igra. Notri, gledajte vaše face.
8 fast break points for Slovenia compared to just 2 for Slovenia, where, you know, yesterday we really saw Slovenia being able to get out and run. And Belgium just doing a good job getting back on defense and kind of taking away the strength of this Slovenia team.
Yeah, as you mentioned, the fast break points, Slovenia on a 8 turnovers at the beginning of the second quarter. And I think if they want to challenge this Belgium team in today's game, I think they gotta start to protect the ball. 8 points from fast breaks for Belgium, it just tells you how much they want today to prepare that the reputation of that yesterday's performance. And they do play great compound defense, and I think Slovenia is going to have a really difficult job today to overcome it.
Belgium, you see, picking up full court, putting a little bit of pressure. Barrett. She stops behind the screen from Evans, and it's good.
This is exactly what Slovenia needs. They need to hit some long shots as well, because if they hit 1-2, obviously the defense, Belgium, will have to change.
And I think it's going to be a foul on Friskovic, number 13. Let's see. I think she was trying to say she got hooked by Mestag, but I think the ref is saying, no, no, no.
You know what, I think the officials has been like a meter away from the action, so
it's easy for us to sit here and say, oh, maybe she got hooked. Missed that. Tough shot. It's no good. Oblak, Slovenia running. Look at this. Oh. Lisets beats everyone down the court, and she just misses the layup. Good job by her.
This is the athleticism of Lisek. She was running over Geldof, over Linskins. Look at that run. Excellent.
She started behind Geldof and Linskins from Belgium. It was also, we forgot about the pass. It was a really nice headman leading pass by, I believe it was Oblak, right?
Yeah, I think we forgot because we already take it for granted that she's a great passer. For Slovenia. Okay, Oblak, 2 assists in today's game.
So it's 6 in yesterday's game to go along with 14 points for Slovenia in that win over Turkey. Alamon. Now Wheelers. Gets it inside.
Oh,
look
at that,
look at that movement. And Almond on the receiving end of a nice pass.
And again, that's the third cut behind the back of the defense. And wow, what a beautiful pass and play when this happens.
Lisets, no good. The ball, I think, goes off of Linskins, and I believe that's now Wheelers. She was underneath the basket trying to rebound, and I think she did get an inverted elbow or something to her head, her mouth. We'll take a look, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's a tough one.
I mean, it wasn't on purpose. So she's walking off the court a little rattled. Go get some ice on that. So Dallaire checking back into the game for Belgium. Lisette. coming off down screen. Oh, tough pass.
It is tough, especially when Geldof at the moment is the highest player on the court.
Yeah.
You want to get the pass to the better angle to deliver that ball to your teammate.
Albon. Finds Linskins, back to Dallaire. Dallaire, she stops behind the screen and knocks it down for 3 points.
7 points for Antonia Dallaire. Great contribution.
Lisitz hesitates and then decides to drive. She stops, 2 point action, no good. Almond to Dallaire, what a beautiful fast break basket by Belgium.
Yeah, and look at Dallaire, 4 points yesterday, and today she already having 9 points in half of the second quarter.
Lisitz, I think Lisitz trying to maybe force the shot a little bit too much now. You know, I know she was scoring early. She does have 11 points. Her teammates aren't scoring well, but you still need it. People need to touch the ball. Other people need to touch the ball, you know?
Yeah, the people need to touch the ball and move as well. If you're gonna come to your offensive half and just take the first shot, that doesn't usually come to
Evans.
Success.
She pops, she's off. Oh, yeah.
This is the quickness of Julie Almond. Like, it's almost like when you're sitting in a car and you just put a higher speed and she just goes.
And this is a completely,
look at that.
Yeah, absolutely. Also, when you put your hand up, like, no, I foul, I wanted a foul. It makes it even more obvious that you're not supposed to just foul to stop the play. You know, that's this whole a new way. Since the last few years, this unsportsmanlike foul, it was put in so you can't just stop the fast break. So if you put your hand up right away, then it looks even more obvious that you weren't trying to make a play on the ball. It wasn't accidental, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And it doesn't really help because the possession is going to stay in Belgium's hands. So
no,
really, you gave them 2 free throws and even the possession. So I would double think that decision next time if to do the unsportsmanlike foul.
Dallaire. Van Loo. Drives, scoops, and misses.
Wow, again, that's another penetration. You have to ask, where is someone for help to cover it? You know, Van Loo, she's not one of the tallest players on the court, so why there is no big or anyone from the weak side to stop this penetration, look at that. It looks like way too late to cover and block possibly this shot.
The foul is going to be on Dubljak, number 20, for Slovenia. So 38-21, Belgium are up with 5 minutes and 14 seconds left in the half.
Straight away lifted up defense to the full court.
Now I believe they're into a zone
defense. Yep. Again, trying to fill that space. And look at that. Again, 2 players on Lisak straight away. That zone defense is actually pretty impressive from Belgian team. And being a Slovenian player, Shanta Evans tries to bounce past that ball to Eva Lisek, but you know, it's quite hard when there is a ball. I would rather look at your small players around the perimeter to maybe
the corner,
stretch the defense. Yeah, look at that. That's like 1, 2, 3, and you have the corner ready, you have strong side ready.
So Belgian ball after that jump ball. Venlo. Mestag. She doesn't hesitate, and it's good.
At least one of the Mestags having a little bit of fire in their hands.
Yep. Anna Mestag.
her second three of the game, 6 points for her. Oblak resets, her shot's off. Good rebound by Dallaire. Ben Liu to Messman. And I believe that foul is gonna be on Oblak, and that might be her third foul in the second half, second quarter, sorry.
Yeah, she seems a little bit tired today after that yesterday's amazing performance supporting her teammate Lisak at 14.6 assists. But she is one of the key maker on the court, and the presence such big for Slovenian team. So I think Coach Gergic might give her a little bit of trust.
Oh! She doesn't hesitate, and she now has three three-pointers and look already how much, in this first half.
Yeah, and how much it means to the bench. Did you see
oh,
it?
Oh, and look there she plays defense. Wide open layup, and it's good. 11 points for Hannah Mestad.
Look how much the bench lives with her as well. Yeah, that was a good penetration from number 20, Tebeliak. Again, she used the driving line towards the rim. Mandlu has been on the side of her body, so again, great look from officials.
So Tebeliak getting some playing time here early in this game. She only played, I believe it was a little over a minute in the game yesterday. So obviously Coach Gergic going to his bench early here. They look tired to me.
Yeah, they do, they do. And that's what I mentioned already when I seen Tao Black that now we see a little zone defense trying to change the rhythm. But yeah, they do. They played such great game yesterday, and in this heat really, it's almost like, again, the opposite way. Belgium looked tired yesterday. Today they look quite like full and focused and composed again. And Slovenia looks a little bit tired. So it's hard. It's hard in this heat to play two quick games.
Yeah.
You know, and I think obviously we can see that Belgium's trying to run the floor so often or anytime they can, and they get the ball quickly to their hands. And that is a physical basketball, and you gotta have really good shape to be able to cope with it.
Two points for Messman. Full court zone defense here. They're gonna trap. That's never where you wanna pick up the ball, right? They're okay. They survived it.
This time they survived. They have to learn not to stop the dribble in that area.
Brazil, she drives, kicks it out. 3-point shot attempt, that's off, but Evans there for the offensive rebound and put back.
And again, she was at the right position at the right time, working it before even the shot has been released. Zone defense, Slovenia.
Inside to Messman, wide open, Vanlo. She lets it fly. She's off, Evans now, pushing the break. And a foul.
But this is the way you stop the fast break. If you want to commit a foul, you don't really reach anywhere.
Use your feet.
To give the officials the option to call down Swansman. Like, this is exactly how you stop it. So great, again, contribution from Hannah Mestak.
So checking back in, we have Julie Allemand and Kim Mestak. Hannah Mestak having a little bit of problems with her shoelace, but Julie Allemand's got her back. She's gonna help her out.
Do you think this break is just to get some
probably
get some
pressure?
Yeah. Actually, no one can say anything, and I think it helped now to get that breath to the defensive possession of Belgium.
Evans. Not a lot going on. 3-point shot attempt, and it's good for Jakovina.
for Slovenia. And they cut into the lead a little bit. Now 49-27 with 2 minutes and 20 seconds left in the second quarter. Julie Almond to Linkskins. She lets it go, and it's good. She got a nice soft touch for a post player.
Yeah, absolutely. It almost reminds me of Sangin Gruda when she lost that shot, mid-range shot. But yeah. Linkskins today, great 8 points, shooting 75% so far.
Strong take, but she's off. Oh, and look at this.
Well, that's a collapse of Slovenian defense, because we could see that after the penetration, all players just stayed in their spots, and there was no one protecting this fast break. There must be always one player, at least, to be safe against these easy baskets. You won't know, but I think it comes a little bit to the tiredness, the fatigue we've seen in Slovenian team, because
two-point jump shot, and it's good for Prizel.
Yeah, because when you're tired, you don't move as good as you normally move.
No,
and if there's no one to protect the fast.
Kim Mestag, 4-3.
Not yet.
She does have one today, right?
Yeah.
Oh, good job by Messman. That's going to be, what, her second block of the game?
I think I'm going to disappoint you. She doesn't have one today yet.
She doesn't have one today?
No, I think it was a 2 point. So at the moment, she's 3-0 from 3 points. So that must have been a long two, the shot we've seen from Kim Mestak earlier.
You know, here's that block by Emma Messman. Her fourth block, sorry, of the game. Fifth block. You're a shooter, and coaches will always tell their shooters, keep shooting, it's gonna go in. I mean, she did make two the other day, yesterday, but it was 2 of 12. It's obviously an uncharacteristic shooting night for Kim Mestag.
Yeah, absolutely, but you know what, like, you can maybe change it for once, try to play for others and change the rhythm, take a long two. But then you gotta go back to that position, because you practiced hours, you practiced years.
Thousands of hours, yeah.
And thousands, and you gotta believe in yourself. And that's what she's doing, because she keeps shooting. And you know what? This is still the group phase. I know every game matters, but if they're gonna qualify further in this tournament, which they hope for, I think it will be really important for her to stay in that shooting rhythm, because it's gonna come.
Yeah, look at that, 6 steals. That have led to 16 fast break points. Not just the steals, of course, but here you see Hannah Mestag. She's already played about the same amount of minutes in this first half that she did the entire game yesterday. Well-deserved minutes. She's doing a great job for this Belgium team. Linkskins to Almond.
Oh, look at that again. But this time, obviously, Tepeliak was more careful.
Skip pass. Telegraph that. Kim Mestag. Difficult pass. Aww. Look at this offense and Delaire.
And you know what? I don't think it was a perfect fast break, but the fact that three players took that energy and run there, that's exactly what happens, because Kim Mestag had a problem a little bit to get that long pass, but still, Delaire didn't give up and she won there for it.
It's just, this is the kind of basketball we've become accustomed to watching from Belgium over the past few years. And I think maybe yesterday's loss was a good awakening. I don't want to say wake-up call, because I think they were ready, maybe a little nervous.
You know, coach has been talking at a press conference before this championship that they don't like that status of being favorites. And I think... Oh! I think this just confirmed the loss yesterday. It just sent the message of, hey, we can still lose. We favorites, but we still can lose. And I think that's what Belgium likes, because they don't want to be completely the favorites.
Yeah.
So today's performance, 55-29, is completely different game from their side.
Yeah, absolutely. So after 20 minutes here in Strasbourg, France, we have Belgium up 55-29. Over Slovenia.
shooting percentage. I mean, look at that. 77%.
And even 40 from three is not bad at all. I think Hannah Mistak has a big contribution to it. 14 rebounds to 19, but look at that assist number. 18 assists during the in first half. Can we see an incredible number by the end of this game?
And another assist category, which I think is interesting. Yesterday against Bosnia, they only had 4 free throw attempts. Today they already have 10, so they're just being more aggressive, right?
Yeah, absolutely. More aggressive, more being themselves. You can see anytime they can, they run fast breaks, but they don't rush. I think the decisions making they're doing today is so much better than they've done yesterday. Yesterday, we've missed that ball movement, the players' movement, but today you can see them everywhere. Everyone's getting touches in every offense, and that's what you want, because every player feels confident to go and attack or play defense because they feel in the game.
Yeah. And a couple highlights from the first half for your viewing pleasure. Lots of highlights, in my opinion, from different Belgian players. You know, Dallaire has done a great job. Back cuts, playing off the ball. Obviously, Messman's always going to be in a highlight when you talk about Belgian basketball. I think Linskens has been great for them. Don't forget Hannah Mestag. She was absolutely superb for them. There you go, that woman right there. Lisets, you know, 11 points, only 2 rebounds. I thought she forced a couple shots, but I think it was more, you know, not in a selfish reason, but in a reason My teammates are struggling scoring. I'm the only one who's really been able to score, so I need to keep shooting. So 11 points for her, and then you have Baric with 6, and then after that, there's not a lot of points.
Yeah, I can only agree with that. I feel Slovenia is dealing a little bit with the fatigue, and it comes to having unforced errors, because Slovenia at the moment on 12 turnovers, which is very high number on the level and trying to compete against Belgium, especially if Belgium's punishing every single one of them so much. So, you know, I think, to be honest, I think Slovenia needs to take that air in the locker room. And the question is, do they play to their standard? Is it all they can offer today? Or is there going to be any surprise from their point of view? It's very hard to play one of the favorites, and especially if they came back to the championship from obviously 15 points lost in the previous game.
Those highlights from game day one. Some big upsets. You saw Belarus knocking off Spain at the buzzer. Serbia coming back and beating Italy when they were down most of the game, and they won in overtime. We saw a big upset win, Bosnia over Belgium. Great game, Russia, against the Czech Republic as well yesterday in our groups. And here, top scorers of today's game after 20 minutes. Ava Lisit, 11 points, 3 of 7 shooting from 2 and 1 of 4. From 3-point range, sorry, 4-point range. Imagine. you know, she's really the only one who's kind of consistently able to score for this Slovenian team. And nothing's really come easy. Yesterday we saw them running, movement, you know, Oblak hitting shots, Krushel hitting shots, Prezel. Today, Friškovic as well. Today, it's been a little harder for them.
Yeah, I think if you play seriously, one of the favorites who has not only the first five, but also the bench full of strength and power and skills, it's very hard. I think in that yesterday's game against Turkey, we know that Turkey didn't come to this tournament as full of leaders as they used to. So it's really hard for Slovenia to then to face the Belgium. Here we see Han Mestak's amazing, let's say, second quarter, 13 points, shooting 100% from 2 and hitting threes from a long distance. And you know what? That's exactly what Belgium team needed as well for their mental kind of comfort, because after this terrible shooting yesterday, this is the Belgium we see today, who we want to see on the podium.
Yeah, and you know, they do kind of rely heavily on Kim Mestak to score, Julie Almond, of course, Messemann to score. So it's great to see, you know, the smile on Hannah Mestak's face there, because it proves that, you know, to play well and to win, you need a contribution. You can't just rely on X amount of players. So good job by her. I think she had 3 points in the first quarter, so maybe 10 in that second quarter.
Yeah, amazing. And it's not just that her teammates plays for her. Here we could see this highlight when she has actually stole the ball and run the fast break herself. So great performance.
Mestak, Hannah Mestak, that is, with 13 points, Dallaire, 3 rebounds, and Messemann, your post player, with 6 assists.
Yeah, we know, because all the attention is on her, or a lot of attention is on her from teams. And I think, obviously, she's showing her qualities. Not only she's a great shooter, but she's also showing her passing ability and making her teammates better, because she is the one knowing that she needs her teammates to succeed at this tournament. So I think that's what she's doing very well today. 6 assists is an incredible number.
And there you see it. On a Mestak, 13 points, 5-6 from the field, including that one steal that led to her fast break layup.
And you know what, Shona? I think it's just the first half, and we see 4 players of Belgium to be in double digits already. That's a great, great, let's say, statistic, because it just tells you having 18 assists within the first half, there's no way that they wouldn't have the people over double digits.
Coming up soon, we'll hear from the coaches.
Philippe, different day, different game. Fun fact, you scored 55 points. It's what you did yesterday during the whole game. So you're making shots, huh?
True, it's another day, like you say. When I didn't recognize my team yesterday the whole game, I think we found back a little bit of fluidity in this first half. And like that, okay, we are up 26. we have more players in the game like that. Okay, we are scoring with a lot more players, so we have already, I think, four goals and double figures. So this is what you need to play, yeah, constant and with constancy and fluid. So, but right now it's still not over, because I know the Slovenian team, they can bounce back right now in quarter three and four. We need to be aware, and also we need to take care also of the bonus we have for the moment, because you never know if we have to calculate at the end of the groups phase. Okay, we need to be ready to take a big win as possible.
Thank you. Please. Have a good one. Coach, you're in a tough spot now. So what's the plan for the second half?
We didn't look good this half. The energy was not okay. Maybe we are tired. I don't know now. But we will try to play better in the second half and show that we know how to play basketball.
Is there a game plan, like something specific or something special?
No, it's not. Just try to play. We know that we can play with them, but they are four times faster than we are in this cup, and this is not normal situation. But like I said, we will try to do the best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, you know, we heard it from the coaches. Mestag, Coach Philip Mestag, obviously happier. I don't want to say he's happy, but he's more happy because now he recognizes his team a little bit more than yesterday. Coach Damir Gregic of Slovenia, disappointed. You know, he says there's nothing really special we need to do. We just kind of need to try a little harder, play a little faster. He says it's unusual teams playing faster than we are. And exactly, I mean, I think a big, the style that Slovenia plays with is with speed, and we haven't seen that here today.
Yeah, I can only agree. And it is kind of hard question for Coach Gergic, what the game plan would be if team of Belgium is playing like they're playing in today's game, where they scored 55 points in the first half, same number as they scored within the whole game yesterday, four players in double digits. So it is really hard to find the weapon that would work against them. So what I think would have to be is to get back the energy what they've had yesterday. Even today look a little bit tired today, and try to put up an aggressive defense, and maybe try to run some quick breaks to get some easy shots, because at the moment it seems like they're working for every basket so hard. Here we see Eva Listed, 11 points, two turnovers, shooting 4 out of 11. She does everything she can, I think, but I would like to see a contribution of the other players as well. We've seen Coach Mestak was mentioning that every point's gonna matter, because they have lost yesterday that game against Bosnia and Herzegovina. This group still can be quite challenging by the end to see who's gonna progress into next phases. So they definitely will go 100% at the end of the game.
Maybe Julie can come back, or maybe Julie will run the back door. Antonia can come into the ball with a small dribble of Emma like that. We have Emma on the side to open, right? And we will attack on the right hand. On the right hand with Julie or with Antonia. And I can have Kim. Oh, sorry, Kim will move up. And I have one new of you in the corner, right? Okay? But keep on going with attacking. Right? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Napadamo, pas, sam, pas na drugu stranu. Ajde, 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 ajmo. Idemo, two down, vrh na pas.
Ajde, 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 ajde. So some last minute instructions there by both coaches to their players before they come out and start this third quarter.
A change in the starting five for the second half, and Slovenian team missing a Prezo instead Baric. And five who start the second half. On the other hand, Belgium, same starting five.
Well, welcome back to the FIBA Women's EuroBasket 2021 edition here in Strasbourg, France. We have Belgium with a big lead over Slovenia and an unfortunate turnover for Slovenia to start the third quarter. That is not what you want to see if you're that man right there.
Yeah, absolutely. 13 turnovers with this one. Way too much if you play Belgium or anyone.
Lundskens going baseline, nowhere really to go. Good defense, Oblak with the steal. She's going. Evans against Lundskens. Kicks it back out, but she gets it back again. A little shot fake. Good job using her body. And Lundskens is called for a foul. So Evans is going to the free throw line.
Yeah, it was great to see that her teammates have left her isolated down under the rim, and everyone else was literally around the perimeter to stretch the defense. So she finally gets some space to play, because if they are not stretched as they were this possession, Evans doesn't really have any space to play, and I think they need her to be in the game offensively.
Yeah, I agree with you. She only has, now she has 4 points on the day. Yeah, you need a little bit more of a scoring contribution from her. So Oblak is gonna pick up her fourth personal foul.
Yeah, I was about to mention that. It's great that coach trusts in her, putting her in that second half.
Oh, she's gonna stay.
She will.
Julie Almond's wide open, finds Dallaire. Dallaire to Messman. Messman hesitates. Maybe could have shot that.
That's a great Lundskens mismatch. Look at that mismatch.
To Almond. Alamon's shot short, and now Slovenia are running.
This is exactly what Slovenia needs to start to do. They need to be a little bit more physical defensively.
Offensive rebound, good job. Maybe a miscommunication there by Belgium, because there was three white jerseys under the basket, but no one went for the rebound. Lisitz, she's gonna take Messman off the dribble. Tough shot, and Mestad comes up with a rebound. Messman, Almond. Gets it back. She goes all the way, finds Kim Mestad! Messman there for the rebound.
And you know what, I have to say, this is the first offensive rebound for Belgium in the game, which is quite interesting. But I think when you shoot the way you shot in the first half,
you don't give yourself any opportunity.
Exactly. So great effort on the glass from Mestar.
Evans.
Pardon, from Messman.
Her shot's off. Keep in mind, Group A and B is happening right now in Valencia, Spain. And at the moment, Italy with a slight lead over Montenegro. 39-32 with just over 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Substitution here. Massey back in. I think Baric is gonna be called on the foul here. That'll be her second foul. Oblak still in the court with those four fouls. What do you think?
I just think, to be honest, that coach knows that the Belgium is a really tough task today. And I think he just trusts his player. Oblak is a very experienced player. And I think it's a big risk, because anything can happen for the fifth foul. And you could be out of game very quickly.
Dallaire drives hard, but Massey there for the offensive rebound. Messman cutting to the basket.
Okay, 6 seconds, five. Someone needs to take that responsibility.
Mesdag falls hard to the ground. She's slow to get up. Lisets, Kriskovic, she lets it fly, and it's no good. Evans with an offensive rebounding foul, and you see, probably soon on your TV, Kim Mesdag is hobbling, but she's not going out. Let's see here. I think she may have like hit knees, you know?
Yeah, that's usually very painful, but it doesn't last too long.
No.
So
she's staying on the court.
Yep, that's what matters.
She didn't come down and play defense that last position, but she'll play offense.
Oh.
Massey! And it's good!
You can see how much it means for her as well. Nika Baric, personal foul.
You know, Billy Massey making her first ever women's Eurobasket appearance. Of course she's excited. That's big time.
And that was a great move from this young player.
But unfortunately, she can't convert the three-point play.
Yeah, Billy Massey playing in Belgium. Top league for Hammer. So, definitely great contribution. 2 points in qualifiers.
Very and she was on that, someone's going to correct me, I believe it was U19 World Cup team for Belgium. They have a good little generation, that team. You know, they made a good run at that World Cup. It was in Thailand back a few years. Oh, my years are all mixing together now with COVID, so I can't exactly tell you what year it was. And she had a great showing there.
Yeah, but what matters is that the young guns are really filling that those spots within the senior
Mesdag
team.
Oy. She goes up hard. Baric takes a hard foul. And guess what? That's going to be her fourth foul now.
Yeah, and that doesn't look too good for Slovenia, as Baric and Oblak is definitely a key backwards combo.
Absolutely, yeah.
For Slovenia, not only offensively, but also defensively. They are a brain of Slovenian team. And who's gonna now take the responsibility for them to be the one aggressive?
So Baric does come out, and Senishar, number 7, checked in for her, but Oblak's still on the court.
Here we see the play caller will be thinking about what else he can do to challenge this Belgium team in today's game. And we see that Belgium is full of energy. They are a completely different team, focused pressing, leading by 32 points, and still are stretching the floor with a full court defense. Coming back into the zone. Evans, and another turnover of Slovenia. Number 15 in this game. And again, it's unforced error, which almost lets you ask the question, like,
Are they tired
that they can't catch the ball or pass the ball? Yeah. It's hard task for them.
They only had 10 turnovers yesterday against Turkey. I do think Belgium plays a lot more aggressive defense than Turkey does.
Yeah, absolutely. They have size, they have skills, and also the change of the defenses makes it hard for Slovenia.
Billy Massey. Oh, for three! And she's cheering. And I'm sure her sister, Becky Massey, on the bench is also cheering for her. Slovenia, slow it down. Oblak wants to run something here. Little floater, it's good.
This is the reason, I think, why Oblak is still on the court, you know, because she's just a core. She's just the brain of the game.
Messman. Tough shot, but it's good.
Yeah, if you won't contest the shot of Messman, there's no way she's going to miss this easy one.
Nice drive, and that's a hard hit from Senishar. Billy Massey committed the foul.
Yeah, Senichar playing in Salia, Slovenian subdivision. She just really got a hard hit.
This is the first of two free throws. And the second offensive rebound. Nope, Dallaire there. Nope, but they stay with it.
Great.
Nice passing. Good fake. And that was a great make by Trebets.
Yeah, that was
number 31.
Great touches, everyone, except for one player. Great move.
Dallaire turns it over. Fast break opportunity now for Slovenia.
And you can see that straight away Coach Mesnak took the key players off the court. Slovenia is using that momentum to score quick 6 points. You see now, I think Coach Mesnak's trying to save some minutes of his key players, because at the moment they're playing most of the game 30 minutes. Four of his players yesterday, almost 30 minutes they played today. They've been Linskens. She had already, like, I will tell you exactly. Linskens had almost 20 minutes. Emma Mesman over 20 minutes. Kim Mesnak 20 minutes. So that's a great decision, being up by 30 to save your key players from Coach Mesnak. But the level has to stay at least the same. It can't drop so badly like it actually done, because Slovenia is a good team and they're going to punish it.
Yeah, and that's, it's interesting that you talk about that, because we know, we'll just take a quick listen here to Coach Mesnak in the timeout. So, they lost to Bosnia, we know this, it happened yesterday. Slovenia beat Turkey. Bosnia beat Turkey today. Belgium can't lose to Slovenia and still think they want to finish first in this group. Finishing first is really important, because then you get an extra day off in a tournament, a short tournament where you have a lot of games.
And especially in these two groups in here when you travel as well.
Absolutely, you need to give, if it's possible, you need to give your players some rest. But you also, you want to win by as much as you can, because in this group especially, points for and against could become important at the end of group play.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And Coach Mesnak's fully aware of it based on that interview halfway through. So I think it's just telling you how much he trusts his bench players as well. So let's hope this timeout is going to get them back to that rhythm they've been before the key players went off the bench. Went on the bench, pardon.
Yeah. Gildoff makes the first of two. She misses, but Massey there for the offensive rebound. Van Loo, hard take to the basket. Her shot's off. Slovenia running.
Back to man to man. Oblak.
Nice three-point shot by Jakovina for Slovenia. And they're slowly creeping back. I mean, like we talked about, points for and against is important. So Slovenia wants to try and score as many points as they can, even if they do lose. Dallaire driving baseline. Tough shot. Good block by Jakovina. Oblak. I think she was trying to hit Trebet. A good defense by Belgium. Hannah Mestag's been quiet this quarter.
I think she's heard you. That's always like that. When you mention something, the players hear us.
Nice.
That's a pretty impressive run from Slovenia.
Yeah. Jakovina, a big part of that.
Yeah, 14-11 in this quarter for Belgium.
Mm-hmm.
Yelduff going to work. She has the height advantage. She finds the lair underneath the basket, and she gets it to go.
And as you mentioned, Jakobina, the previous possession, she only scored 3 points in that yesterday's game on the 8 minutes. And today, she's already on 10 points. Great contribution from this guard.
Prezel, Febitz, back to Oblak. Shot clock winding down. She gets it off. It's long. Pretty big collision under the basket. But it's a no call. And a shot clock violation. Belgian ball. Nestag.
Great deflection from Sunny Charge. Stop that organized offense with Belgium.
So we have Messman and Julie Allemand check back in. 1 minute, 27 seconds to play in this third quarter. 71-42 for Belgium. Travel, yeah.
We almost flew with Julie Man Van Loo. Obviously, you gotta put the ball back. Bounce on the floor earlier, but like sooner than you step.
Slovenia here trying to get something going. Prezel with a little shot, and it goes. Geldof. She goes up, uses her height advantage, and is able to draw the foul.
We definitely have to give a credit to Slovenia that they didn't really give up after the halftime, because this quarter is 16-15, and we always talk how important the third quarter is of the game. And if they can bounce off this quarter in the fourth quarter and get a little bit more Belgium under the pressure, I'm sure they could make some mistakes as well, especially with some substitution on the Belgian side. And you could see now Geldof was posting up, and there was a three defensive players for Slovenia trying to grab the ball.
Good job there by Geldof. She has 3 points today. Baric.
The deflection by Almond. Again, to stop the break, 6 seconds on the time. Shot clock.
Shot clock winding down. Offensive rebound. Another offensive rebound by Senesher. I believe she came up with those two offensive rebounds, but they weren't able to convert. 15 yeah. seconds left in the end of the third quarter. Belgium are gonna hold the ball and take the last shot. Julie Allemand goes hard. She can't convert, but Messman's there for the rebound. And it was off. So at the end of the third quarter, Belgium 73-44 for Slovenia.
Yeah, some stats numbers in here. 69, 2 points, 36 for Belgium from threes. Not bad for Slovenia. 36 is very low number, only 12 out of 33 from the field. And it comes to the great defense of Belgium team as well. They don't let Slovenia create as much as they used to and as much as they actually created in that yesterday's game when Teja Oblak had 6 assists and all the others contributed as well. So what is interesting is that the Slovenian team has grabbed 12 offensive rebounds in this game so far, and I think that could be one element what Belgium needs to start to think about it, because obviously they will play teams where if they gonna allow them to grab as many offensive rebounds, it could be quite a big element in the games in the future. So that's one thing I think they should focus in this last quarter, to not let Slovenia to grab any offensive rebounds, just even if it's just a practice kind of wise for a farther stage of the tournament or farther games of this group actually first.
Yeah, I agree with you. I wonder how long we'll see kind of the starters. I mean, they have Kim Mestad back in, Messman, Linskins, Alamon, and now Wheelers. So she's not a starter, but I wonder how long they'll stay in to try and keep their players fresh. I know it's an off day tomorrow. This is their second game in a row, a disappointing and a hard game for them yesterday against Bosnia. They lost 55-70, and they just looked tired in that game. They did not move like we have seen them move in the past, or like they are moving today. Messman to Mestag. Mestag lets it fly, and it's good!
You can see the face of Kim Mestag. 1 out of 5, finally, let's say, in that case.
Lisette, can she answer? She can't, but guess who's there for the offensive rebound?
That's a great hustle from Senichar.
Senichar, and that is going to be her fourth offensive rebound.
Yeah, and 13 team ones. So I'm sure when Coach Mestak's gonna look back at this game, it's gonna be definitely one thing to improve on the Belgian side.
Julie Alamon, nice hands. Messman. How do you stop that?
There's no way you can stop this. Great lead by Julie Alamon, stealing the ball and quickly started fast break. 7th assist of Julie Alamon.
Three-point shot, and now her 5th offensive rebound.
What an effort. What a hustle from Senichar.
Yeah, absolutely. Hustle plays. Gorsic is going to be called for the travel.
Senichar has played in Celje, Slovenia, top division. During the qualifiers, only averaged 20 points and 2 points and 5.2 rebounds. So no surprise that she's really hustling on that glass.
Now Wheeler's out to Mestag. I think that was a long 2.
Yeah, and this is exactly what we were speaking early. She gotta keep shooting. It's gonna come.
Prezel to Barich. Barich lets it fly, and it's no good. Now Wheeler's with the rebound. She's pushing it.
Yeah, it's good to see her back after the shake, which you got earlier. It was important for the mental.
Messman. Catch and shoot from the baseline.
Emma Messman.
2 more points for her.
But what incredible, it's 20 points, but she's shooting 9 out of 10 from the field. What a percentage, 7 assists, another great performance.
3-point shot, that looked on to me, but it was just long from Gorsic.
Look at that.
Messman, easy, way too easy, nice pass by Kim Mestag.
I know what, or I guess what's gonna be the talking point on the Slovenian bench. You gotta stop the break, protect the ball, don't rush your offense, because again, you come to your offensive half and after first pass, you're gonna take a shot. You're just giving the opportunity to Belgium to run the breaks and increase that margin in the score.
What do you think about 29 assists
for Belgium. How unselfish are they?
I just think that's the Belgium we know. Slovenia 10 assists but 20 turnovers. And to your previous questions, 29 assists, and it's not even over. We're still at the beginning of the fourth quarter. I just think that's incredible, and that's something what young players should watch, how to share the ball, how to play the team basketball. But you know what? It's not a surprise to me that Belgium plays this way, because that's exactly why they are one of the favorites of this tournament. Rebounds, 29 assists, only 8 turnovers, 11 steals. Those are some of the stats of the Belgium team so far. And it's just joy to watch, to be honest. Everyone's getting touches, and what more everyone feels in the game, what is so important for the other games as well. Prezo. Gorsic, Prezo. Good look, Lisak.
And she hasn't scored in this second half.
Yeah, she has been very quiet. To be honest, she didn't get as many balls in her position either, but yeah, I think she's running out of breath a little bit as well, to be honest. Not only one player, but I think whole team looks a bit tired after that yesterday's great win over the Turkey. Another offensive rebound for Slovenia. 16th offensive rebound. Brazil.
What a defense.
What a defense from Belgium. Really has been every time covering the driving line. No one really made any error and played a defense all 24 seconds. Well deserved possession for Belgium. Now we see Marjorie Capriol on the court for the first time at this championship for Belgium. Another great call for Coach Mestak.
And oh, I was just about to say, another assist for Belgium. Nice pass, Dallaire to Messman. Foul. Emma Messman, 24 points already.
For now, 100% shooting, 33 from that line. Oh, always when we say it happens.
Slovenia running. Gorsic. Friskovic. And a turnover, another turnover. Linskins leading the break.
You know what Dallaire. I like on the Belgian team is, oh, but
Capriol
again. Right,
finds Mestak underneath the basket, and she scores.
And this extra pass just makes such a huge difference. Not only because Marjorie Capriol knows that Kim's struggling a little bit from the long distance, but give her 2 points if you can.
Yeah, Mestak, Kim Mestak with 11 points on the game. Oh, nice cut.
Double digits in half of the fourth quarter. Now we see Gorsic, Kim Mestak. You know, you just said she scored 11 points already, and considering that she only hit 1 3, which is her strength on the court,
yeah,
it's again great performance, even though she's not sharp. Another offensive rebound for Slovenia.
Crucial. The one who shot that and got her rebound. Refs are going to stop and make sure that the shot clock is correct.
a little pause till officials gonna decide how much time do they have to put back on the or take off the clock. You know, some interesting statistics. Slovenia 17 offensive rebounds and 19 defensive. At 36 rebounds so far compared to 24 of the Belgians. Yeah, here we see it.
Okay.
7 seconds on the shot clock they're asking for.
Yeah.
So that seven seconds.
So that's not much left for Slovenia to attack, so you would assume that they're probably gonna call some set offense from the baseline to get some position open.
So Messman, Allemans are on the bench. Mestag, Linskins, Dallaire, the starters for Belgium, are still on the floor. 3-point shot, that's long. Mestag with the rebound. Just over five minutes left in the fourth quarter. Belgium up 85, Slovenia 44. Everything, for the most part, is going right for Belgium today. Nice pass from Caprio to Linskins.
And this is Caprio's game. She loves that entertainment of great passes. And what more, Shona, is a 32nd assist for Belgium team in this game.
Yeah, that's just absolutely incredible. Backdoor pass and another turnover by Slovenia. It's gonna be their 23rd turnover. They only have 10 assists.
Kind of feel we have a game of extremes because we see a 32 assists for Belgium team and then 23 turnovers for Slovenia, 17 offensive rebounds. Those are numbers you don't see every game.
Yeah. Mestak. Foul. On Slovenia, I believe it's on Friskovic.
Yeah, on the second team foul, so it's gonna be sideline possession.
See Evans, Oblak, Baric, all on the bench, maybe resting up. Caprio. Surprised that was not called. She easily grabbed her with, like, it was an unsportsmanlike foul that Lisette's got away with.
Yeah. Whoa, look at that. Oi. That doesn't look good.
Adamon did check back into the game.
That was a great break run by Belgium again. That risky pass from starting at the Capio to Alamon, and
she's grabbing her ankle.
Yeah, I think she just twisted her ankle trying to cover the Gelber, heading to the basket in that last second.
Let's see. Oh yeah.
And I think, you know, it comes a little bit to that being tired, because once you're tired, these injuries happen, because you don't think about your body as much as when you're fresh and ready to go.
Second game in a row.
Yeah.
It's hot.
It is hot.
And I are hot. Imagine if you were running up and down the court.
Yeah, absolutely. And Jakovina done great today. She scored 10 points in today's game. Like 10 minutes, which is not a lot, but as you mentioned, this heat, I think any minute is a lot.
Yeah. Welcome, number 25, to your first ever FIBA Women's Eurobasket competition. Billy Massey has checked in for Belgium. She did replace the injured Raman, Jenna Raman. Nice little left-hand layup there by Trebitz. who broke her thumb in a freak accident on their travel day here to Strasbourg, France. So they brought in Becky Massey, who had been practicing and training with the team anyway. So it's not, you know, it was an easy decision for Coach Philip Mestag. Ramon will be back and ready to go, hopefully, by the Olympics.
Yeah, you definitely want to hope for, because Ramon is a key element of this team. Oh, it's a three-point
devil,
yuck.
Caprio drives. Linskin, a little long.
I see Sunny Char posting Alaman down in there.
Zero movement from Slovenia right now.
Absolutely. It was just one post up isolation. But if you decide to play it, you gotta give her the ball and reward her for the hard work of posting up.
So here we see Jakovina. Well, I believe it's a little bit of an ankle sprain. So getting some ice on that as quickly as possible. I'm sure she'll be getting treatment all day today, this evening, and then again tomorrow on the off day, and hopefully we'll see her back on Sunday, ready to play.
Yeah, that's always you want to see the injured players coming back as quick as they can, but obviously for healthy reasons, safely as well. So wishing her speed recovery from this little sprain.
So in Group B action, Italy has started to pull away from Montenegro. Just under 3 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. 74-54 for Italy. Don't forget, basketball fans, the FIBA Women's America Cup is happening right now in Puerto Rico. Semifinals are gonna be played late at night, our time, because of the time change. Don't forget to check those games out. Massey to Linskins, Caprio wide open. Her three-point shot is long. I believe it's a rebounding foul on Brazil.
Yeah, it was again a very unselfish play from Linskins opening up Marta Caprio. She had to shoot it. She had bigs for a rebound. She has to shoot it, even though she's not one of the
Alman
shooters.
She drives. Caprio. Julie Alman. Her three-point shot is off.
I kind of think when the key players of Belgium were on the court, they played without the ball, great movement. Instead of this five at the moment. But, oh,
nice shot by Trebit.
Yeah, and this five on the floor is at the moment playing a lot with the ball. And that's not the game Belgians want to play. So far, 19-7 in this quarter for Belgium. Not bad at all. But I'm sure Belgium wants to just look at the style they play. They want to bring that good momentum of the game to the third day of playing.
Like that, I have, for example, Serena, or I have Billy. This is up to you, right? One of the two. Okay. So what I want now, we're gonna push the ball, Majul. You pass it to the top. Becky will. Billy, you go a little bit away. You go in. You post up. You post up. We go on top. We pass it. We feed it in, and we have continuity behind.
Crazy number we see now on the screen. 34 assists
and only 8 turnovers.
On the 8th. I don't know if it tells you that Slovenia didn't play as aggressive defensively as they played yesterday against Turkey, or it does tell you that simply the players of Belgium really protect the ball and know every ball matters. I think Slovenian team looked a little bit fatigued in today's game, and they didn't really challenge Belgium as much as they probably would have wished for. Oh, possession Belgium. Almost looked like a flopping. Coach Mestak doesn't like that call. I don't think Becky Massey done so much for Tepievi, the Beliak, to just fall on the floor like this. Call has been made, Slovenia position. Brazil falling. Great defense from Belgium.
Yeah. Brazil gets it back. Nice little curl. 2-point shot for her, and it's good. Julie Elleman now slowing it down a little bit. Do you think it would be a pretty cool experience to have your sister on the court, both in your first Eurobasket? I'm sure we will see the Massey sisters for a long time with this Belgium program.
Yeah, absolutely. It's something probably they might dreamt of as a young players, but now the reality actually came through.
Yeah. Slovenia, Trebitz, nice shot. It's good for 2 points. She's played well tonight.
Yeah, she definitely did, but more, it's 6 quick points for Slovenia again.
Becky Massey, nowhere to go, passes it to her sister. Round to Almon. Almon hands it off, beautiful pass, but Geldof misses the easy basket.
Yeah, she knows this is the basket you gotta make, no matter what, and she tried to tip it to Caprio, who was actually expecting her to make that easy too. Here's the Trebić, great 2 points mid-range.
One last possession for Slovenia. Can they get a basket? Because like we talked about, points for and against could become important. 3-point shot attempt, it's long. Offensive rebound, not time to pass it. And that is it, folks. Belgium. 92 to Slovenia, 57. And it's exactly the kind of Belgian basketball performance that you expect, that we didn't see yesterday. And it made me a little worried. I am not as worried anymore since watching this game. How do you feel, Teresa?
Yeah, I feel absolutely the same. And we have to consider that the Belgian team still didn't shoot their best from the 3 points. But what more, they adjusted the point-wise, and we could see a so much better movement in this game than compared to the yesterday's ones. And just the 34 assists in this game demonstrate how team-wise they stepped up since yesterday, and they just showed us who they're capable of. Because if they play like this, if you consider they're gonna hit some long distance as well, they're gonna be very hard to be stopped from to get to the podium. And what's important as well, here we see some stats and confirmation, what we said, 69% from twos. That's an incredible number. But you know what, I think they a lot of points, I don't have that stat now, but a lot of points they run out of fast breaks. So obviously that's why the percentage is so high as well. 27 rebounds for Belgium, 41 for Slovenia. Well, I have to say 18 offensive rebounds for Slovenia could be a little bit alarming for a Belgian team. Because if they're gonna face a better teams, it could be a quite key factor in the game.
Yeah, exactly what I was thinking. We'll get a look at some of the top plays from this second half. Mesman, what can she not do? Offensive rebound there.
Yeah, what was, I think, as well important is that Coach Mestak has saved his key players in today's game a little bit. Decrease that minute load they've had during that first game. So I think generally Coach Mestak is gonna be definitely happy as he recognizes his team today, as he mentioned. But still, there are things to improve to the next game.
Yeah, absolutely. But I just think the turnaround from their first game against Bosnia and Herzegovina compared to today. There you see Kim Mestak's three. And she smiles because she says, finally. So clearly she's not shooting the three well, but she's doing everything else for her team to win. I thought they were a lot quicker. They looked like they were in shape today. So yesterday, I don't know if they just weren't ready and the heat affected them or if it was something more mental, but they physically looked like a better team today as well. And Slovenia typically play a very high octane, moving, sprinting game, and they took Slovenia out of what they want to do.
Absolutely. Belgium completely dictated tempo of today's game, and I think it was a very hard task for Slovenia to convince them, hey, look, no, we want to play our game. There's no way Belgium would have allowed it today. I have to highlight as well 10 assists for Julie Alleman. Excellent point guard against Kills, showing that why you consider her as one of the best point guards. Only 6 points, but you know what, hell, you're making your teammates better. The team's leading, and as always, what matters by the end. 5 players in double digits, what more Coach Mestak could ask for?
Yeah, he's still a coach, right? So he's going to find something that he thinks that his team can do better. And like you said, I think it's going to be the offensive rebounds that they gave up. But just a much, much better performance than yesterday. So here you see it, game day 2, Group C, Bosnia 2-0, Belgium get their first win, Slovenia already have 1 win. And 0-2 for Turkey. Shona Thorburn and Teresa Brundlebutt, we're gonna say goodbye and we'll see you here shortly.
The way they can play, so.